Welcome back. We continue on Westmoreland on the Gridiron on the Westmoreland Sports Network, and it is now time for our interview with our Player of the Week, our Westmoreland Sports Network Player of the Week. This week is Anthony Govern from the Southmoreland Scotties, and what a game that he had in Week 3 in the Scotties' conference opening victory against the South Allegheny Gladiators. He passed for 170 yards, he ran for 108, he combined for 5 touchdowns. Anthony, congratulations on being voted Player of the Week this week.
Thank you. It means a lot.
Well, you certainly meant a lot to the Scotties last week, and you do every single week. A big victory for you again against South Allegheny to start out conference play. What did you like most about your team's performance last week in that win?
We knew coming in that it was a big section game, so the guys stepped up big, and we executed when we needed to do. We controlled the clock very well, made some big plays. I'm not going to lie, I got to give a lot of credit to the line. Without them, we wouldn't be anything.
Yeah, they've certainly done a nice job for you this year, and I want to ask you about that big fourth quarter you had. You possessed the ball for basically the entire quarter. How much confidence does that give you going forward, knowing that when you get into the fourth quarter, if you guys have a lead, you can close the game out because you did it in the fourth quarter against South Allegheny? Does that give you confidence going forward?
It gives us a lot of confidence. It's nice knowing that we can keep our run game going late in the game. It makes it easier on our offense and our defense when we can run the ball. I mean, it gets our defense off the field, and a lot of guys aren't even playing both ways, so it's nice to get the defense off the field when we can.
What did you like most about the way that you specifically played in the game against South Allegheny?
I think I played all right. I mean, obviously I need to complete more than 8 of 18 passes, but overall I think I had pretty good pocket presence, and the way I can avoid pressure and still get the ball down the field, I think my receivers did a wonderful job. It was just a great team win.
Well, now that you mentioned, I wanted to ask you about, you know, you moving to quarterback a little bit later on, but is it still kind of a learning process for you? You've done a great job, but in terms of, you know, wanting to complete more passes, like you said, I mean, is that something that, you know, you can get better at each and every week because it's more of a new position for you?
Definitely, but there's obviously no excuse. I mean, I'm there to do what the coach has asked me to do. I just need to execute better and go from there.
Coach Kiefer said after the game that you guys knew it was your conference opener. Did you practice with a little more intensity knowing that, or were you just more focused? What do you think kind of made you guys really, you know, focus on the fact that, hey, this is our conference opener, we have to win this game?
Well, you know Coach Kiefer as well as I do. There's not a day that we aren't intense. I mean, we just emphasize that we need to stay focused throughout the whole week and keep our eyes on our goal.
Yeah, we love talking about Coach Kiefer. Give us a sense of what it's like to play for him. I'm sure it's not too hard to stay motivated.
Oh, no, this dude, before games, I feel like he's going to run through the brick wall.
You formed a connection with Isaac Trout. He also intercepted a pass on defense last week, but he had a big week. What makes your connection so special with Isaac?
Well, I mean, we've been best friends for a very long time. I mean, we've literally been playing football together since we were 6 years old. I mean, our connection is pretty great. We know exactly what each other are capable of doing, and I think that's what makes us very dangerous.
Is there anything defenses you've noticed that are doing differently against Isaac? Or, I mean, is it just that you guys are that much, I guess, that good that you can keep connecting like this?
I mean, my receivers know, not only Isaac, but all my receivers, J.J. Bloom, Josh Bass, they all know that I can keep the play going, so they just find the holes, and then I keep my eyes down the field and connect to them.
Yeah, Bloom had a big week last week as well. I'm sure that kind of helps you out. That way, you know, defenses can't always spy on Isaac. Coach Kiefer mentioned after the game about cleaning up the penalties. So what do you have to focus on to eliminate those, Anthony?
We just got to stay disciplined. I mean, during the game, we get a little excited and a little fired up, and it's great. I love it, but we need to do it between the whistles and do the right things.
You've played multiple positions during your high school career, and now you're the quarterback. And honestly, as I mentioned earlier, you've made it look easy. How has it come so natural to you, and what do you think has been the key to your success this year?
The coaching staff has been a huge part of making me the best that I can be. I mean, obviously, there's still a lot of room for improvement, and I have to give a huge shout-out to my linemen, Ben Yeske, Corey Ansel, Aiden Corvin, Mason Niederheiser, Caleb Tax, and even Joey Stebbins. Without them, like I said, we are nothing as a team. And I think being a pitcher in baseball, I knew that I had the arm strength. I just need to get the technique down.
Well, I'm glad you mentioned another sport because I want to ask you about wrestling. And, of course, we've got to give a shout-out to Coach Boring as well, who always takes care of us. All of you guys take care of us when we're in the gym calling wrestling. And I know you still have a lot of football season to go and hopefully playoff games and everything. But how excited are you for the wrestling season once it gets here?
Oh, I'm super excited. I've had one goal since I started as a freshman, and that's the 100 wins. I want that so bad.
How close are you, Anthony?
I'm at 67 right now.
All right. I think you'll get there. We'll all be rooting for you for sure.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
Yeah, absolutely. We love covering you guys, certainly, and certainly a lot of fun. So, you know, you have baseball, you have wrestling, you have football. Would you like to play a sport in college, and are you leaning towards one right now?
I'm not leaning towards anything right now, not even a school. I'm just waiting for the best opportunity to get thrown at me. I'm keeping my options open.
That's the best way to do it. So Southmoreland kind of flew under the radar coming into the year maybe, but certainly not anymore. What are your team goals? Have they changed at all based on how you guys have started the year?
No, they haven't changed at all, actually. We knew coming in summer workouts that we wanted a section title and a couple playoffs win. That's been our goal since we've stepped foot on the field, and we know what we need to do for that to happen, and we're just going to keep working for that to happen.
Looking ahead to Friday, you guys play Mount Pleasant. In case you didn't know, huge game, rivalry game. What's the excitement level like in practice this week, and how do you envision it being on Friday night?
Oh, you don't even have to say anything to the guys right now. They just know it's a Mount Pleasant week. We came in Monday and started going. We know how big this game is, and to be honest, the seniors want this game more than anybody else right now.
Should make for a great one. What do you need to do well to beat Mount Pleasant? You know, what are some of the things maybe they do well and you guys have to kind of counteract and get this win on Friday?
We just need to execute. I mean, we need to follow the game plan going in and just don't give up. We know that it's not going to be the same team that we watched on film. It's a rivalry, so they're going to come out with intensity and we will just come out with a little more.
And you have to be looking forward to it because, you know, last year there weren't big crowds. This year, there will be a big crowd on Friday night. I'm sure you're really looking forward to that, too.
Oh, the atmosphere in these games are unbelievable. Even non-rivalry, like when LH came to town, McGuffey, even when we went to Perry, we had a pretty big crowd. So it's just great to be back. It's so much fun.
Yeah, you played some interesting non-conference games this year. Laurel Highlands, you mentioned Perry. What's that been like?
Oh, it's been fun. I mean, I think we had three very hard non-conference games. I think they're all solid teams. And I don't know enough about the rest of the teams, but we face a lot of team speed in those first three games, and I don't know that we'll see anybody that fast the rest of the year.
Yeah, definitely gets you ready for conference play. We are talking with our Week 3 Westmoreland Sports Network Player of the Week, Anthony Govern, as he was able to lead the Scotties to a victory over the South Allegheny Gladiators. Anthony, this has been great, but we still have our quick six questions for you. You ready for them?
Oh, I'm ready.
All right. Let's take a little bit of a closer look at Anthony Govern. So first of all, what is your favorite thing about playing football, and how long have you played?
I've been playing for about 14 years. I started when I was 4 years old. Mm-hmm. And the best thing about this game is the brotherhood that you form with all the guys. I mean, this is the most team chemistry that Southmoreland has had in a very long time. And I believe that it helps every Friday night.
Yeah, I believe in our training camp preview, you mentioned that, how much team chemistry you guys have. It has certainly helped you out on Friday nights. What are some of the things you do for fun, Anthony?
I like to hunt and fish, but during football season, I watch a lot of film. And my dad has told me on multiple occasions to quit watching film. It's 1 o'clock in the morning.
It's time to go to bed, right?
Yeah.
That's pretty cool. Who's the guy on the team that cracks the jokes and keeps things light? And I know that's not easy with Coach Kiefer around, but, you know, who's the guy that can kind of, I don't know, keep everybody loose?
J.J. Bloom, for sure. There's not a day goes by where he doesn't say something to get all the guys laughing. He even gets Coach Kiefer to laugh, and that's saying something.
That's tough, isn't it?
Oh, we could be getting ran over and over and over again, and JJ still has a joke to say, and we all laugh about it and have a good time, and then get right back into work.
That's fantastic. How about your favorite sports movie?
The Field of Dreams.
Did you watch the baseball game at the Field of Dreams park?
Oh, it was unbelievable.
How awesome was that? I hope they do that more often. I think they are going to maybe play more games there next year.
I hope so. That was sick.
Kevin Costner comes out. I mean, and the players come through the you know, the fence out there and the cornfield. Yeah. I mean, it really was so cool. When you go to Dairy Queen, what kind of blizzard do you order? Are you a big Dairy Queen guy?
I like the strawberry cheesecake blizzard, actually.
All right. I'm more of an Oreo guy, but I see where you're coming from there. If you could meet one person, past or present, could be a celebrity, could be an athlete, could just be anybody, who would it be?
I'd have to say James Harrison. I mean, the dude played with some crazy intensity, and I love it. I inspire to be everything he ever was.
Yeah, there aren't more physical guys, even in NFL history, than James Harrison, that's for sure. Biggest influence on your life, Anthony, who would you say that would be, you know, that's helped you along and things like that?
I actually have two. My dad, Alan Govern, and my late grandfather, Randy Govern. I mean, they both played a huge part in athlete and the man I am today. I mean, for as long as I can remember, we were outside throwing football or baseball, and they would always teach me the same things over and over again. But I'm so glad that they did. I mean, I couldn't thank them enough.
Well, not only have they made you a great player on the field, I know you're a good student, and this conversation was great. We always love talking with you, whether it's during football season. And don't worry, we will talk to you during wrestling season, that's for sure. Smitty and those guys will be talking with you multiple times, I'm sure. This was fantastic. Thank you so much, Anthony. Good luck this weekend as you guys play Mount Pleasant and the rest of the season. We'll talk again soon, okay?
All right, thank you.
That was Anthony Govern, our Player of the Week for Week 3. Again, he ran for 108 yards, passed for 170, combined for 5 touchdowns against South Allegheny. We'll be back on Westmoreland on the Gridiron as we take a look at Week 4 games, including Mount Pleasant and Southmoreland, here on the Westmoreland Sports Network.